In this video, we're going to finish the factoring by grouping worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 20, we're going to be grouping the first two terms together and the last two terms together. We have a 4m as the GCF in the first two terms, since 4m times 4n gives us 16mn, and 4m times m gives us 4m squared. And then in the second grouping, we have a 7 as the GCF. So that'll leave us with 4n minus m. And now you can see we have our common binomial, so we can write this as 4m plus 7 times 4n minus m. And that is our solution in number 20. In number 21, grouping the first two terms and the last two terms, I have a 7 in common between my 56 and 35, and I also have an x in common. So I'll take out a 7x to get 8y minus 5, and then in my next two terms, I have a 2 in common. So I'll pull out a 2, and I also have an r in common. So I'll pull out a 2r to be left with 8y minus 5. Since I took out the GCF, I have a common binomial now, and I can factor. 7x plus 2r will get multiplied to 8y minus 5 to give me my factored solution and number 21. And also remember, since multiplication is commutative, I could also have gotten 8y minus 5 times 7x plus 2r, just depending on which term I wrote first. However, either answer is correct because those are equivalent. In number 22, grouping my first two terms together, I'll have a GCF, or greatest common factor, of 3, since 3 goes into 21 and 3 goes into 15, and also x. So I'll be left with 7y plus 5. Since 3x times 7y is 21xy, and 3x times 5 is 15x. Then, in my second grouping, with my last two terms, I have a 5 in common, and not just a 5, I also have an r. So taking out a 5r, I'll have 7y plus 5. Since 5r times 7y is 35ry, and 5r times 5 is 25r. Now that I have a common binomial, I can factor that out. So I'll have 3x plus 5r, and I'll multiply that to 7y plus 5. 3x plus 5r times 7y plus 5 is my solution in number 22. In number 23, grouping my first two terms together, I can pull out an a squared. So I'll have 5z minus 4c. And in my next grouping, I can pull out an x, and I can also pull out a 3. So pulling out 3x, I'll get 5z minus 4c. And if you want to double check, multiply a squared to each of the terms, and then multiply 3x to each of the terms to see if you get our original polynomial. Now though, since I have a common binomial, I can factor that out. So I'll have a squared plus 3x times 5z minus 4c. And that is my solution in number 23. Now remember that I want a common binomial when I factor out the GCF of each of the groupings. However, let's rewrite this so that the constant is last. So I'll have 4xy plus negative x plus negative 24y plus 6. Now I'll group my first two terms together and the last two terms together. In the first two terms, I'll be able to pull out an x. So I'll have 4y, and that'll be minus 1. Since x times 4y is 4xy, and x times 1 is x, but since that's subtracted, it's the same as adding. Next, I'll pull out a negative 6. So then I'll have 4y minus 1. And now that I have my common binomial, I'll have x minus 6, or plus a negative 6, times 4y minus 1. That is going to be my solution in number 24. Now note that if I group my first two terms and my last two terms together at the start, I would have 2 times 2xy plus 3, and that would get added to negative 1 times x plus 24y. So pulling out the GCF of both of those, the binomials do not match. That's why I have to order my terms before I group them together. In number 25, if I were to start by grouping my first two and last two terms together, I'd pull out a 3, and that's the only thing that 21xy minus 12b squared has in common. So I'd still have 7xy minus 4b squared. And in my next terms, I could pull out a 2b. So then I'd have 7x minus 9y. However, when I pull out the GCF, my binomials do not match. So I'm going to have to reorder number 25. I'm going to reorder it by saying 21xy, and I'm going to move my other term with x closer so that I can group those together. So 21x plus 14xb, then I'm going to add my negative 12b squared, and then I'm going to add my negative 18by. Now I'll group the first two terms and the last two terms together. In doing this, I can pull out a 7x. So that's a lot more than I could pull out of the first two terms in the last ordering. So pulling out a 7x, I'll have 3y plus 2b. And when I pull out the GCF of the next two terms, I'll pull out a negative 6b. Pulling out a negative 6b, I'll be left with 2b plus 3y. 2b plus 3y is the same as 3y plus 2b, so I have a common binomial. So I'll have 7x minus 6b times 3y plus 2b. And remember, the order in which we add doesn't matter. That is why those binomials are the same. 7x minus 6b times 3y plus 2b. And number 26, again, I'm going to start by reordering. I'm going to have 9mz, and I'm going to move my term with my m over. So 9mz plus 3mc. I'll add a negative 4nc and then subtract or add that negative 12nz. Grouping my first two terms and my last two terms together, I'll pull out a 3m. So that will give me 3z plus c. And in my next two terms, I'll pull out a negative 4n. So that'll give me a positive c plus 3z. And you can see I have a common binomial since 3z plus c is the same as c plus 3z. So I have 3m minus 4n, and that will be multiplied to 3z plus c. And that is my solution and number 26. 3m minus 4n times 3z plus c. In number 27, I want my constant to be at the end. So I'll have 28xy plus 35x plus 20y plus 25. Now I can group and simplify. Pulling out the GCF of 7x, I'll have 4y plus 5. And then pulling out the GCF of 5, I'll have 4y plus 5. You can see that I do indeed have a common binomial, so I can write this as 7x plus 5 times 4y plus 5. And that is my solution in number 27. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 28. But before I do number 28, remember to subscribe to my channel and like this video. Now I'm going to have to reorder, so since u squared is my greatest exponent, I'll write 36u squared at the start. And then I'll add that to 30uv. And that will get added to 30u, which will get added to 25v. 36u squared plus 30uv plus 30u plus 25v. Now I'll group my terms. 6u is my GCF, so I'll have 6u plus 5v. And 5 is my GCF in my next grouping, so I'll have 6u plus 5v again. Now I can write this as 6u plus 5 times 6u plus 5b. 6u plus 5 times 6u plus 5v. And remember, addition is commutative, so I could also write this as 6u plus 5 times 5v plus 6u. And with that, we wrap up our factoring by grouping worksheet. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Also, subscribe and like my channel. And don't forget that if you do not have a common binomial when you factor at first, reorder and factor again.